Good morning, students. Today I'm going to start next lesson in your class, that is minerals and mining. So, what lesson I'm going to start today? Minerals and mines. See that first. What are minerals? What type of minerals are available in the region of Telangana? And types of minerals, and how we are mining the minerals? Examples of mining in the region of Telangana, how we are mining. These are all the things I'm going to cover in today's class. So first of all, you see that where we found the minerals. Take an example, house as an example. In the dialing, we are seeing and we are also using lot of minerals. First of all, our house was constructed by using with the iron, steel, cement and rocks, and these are all the things. So everything which we found in our home, there is some link up with our lesson, that is minerals. You can say the Kalapa stone, granite, marbles and cement is made with the limestone, and also we have the sandstone and white color stones, and we have the Kalapa stone. There are some different type of stones which are using in the construction of houses. Even that our walls is made with the whitewash. The whitewash is also made with the sandstone and also the limestone. Even that cement preparation, in the preparation of cement, there is some lot of minerals are playing crucial role. Take an example, the limestone is one of the important raw material for preparation of the cement. So imagine that without cement, without iron, and there is no way for construction of houses. Even once upon a time, in the construction of houses, they are using that mud. Even that is also one of the mineral. Even the sand is also one of the mineral. Even you see that long years before, the people are using that for the purpose of preparation of food. Preparation of food is also using that firewood. So that is also one of the mineral. Even that water is also one of the mineral that which we are using for drinking purpose, even that washing purpose, everything that you can say that minerals. So there are a lot of minerals can found that even you see that without vehicles we cannot travel nowadays. That vehicles preparation is also linked up with the minerals. And you see that we have that cars, buses, bikes, these all are running with the petroleum and also the diesel. So these all the things also can found in the ground in the form of crude. They say that crude oil can found in the ground, in the ground level. So that is also one of the thing. So crude oil is also can found in the ground. That is also one of the minerals. So even that which we like very much, that you can say that silver jewelry, and also that the gold, silver, gold, and also the diamonds, these also found in the ground in the different manner. So the thing we are saying that everything, there is some which we are living in the modern days, just link up with the minerals. So one more time I will come with the minerals. Lot of minerals we have that in the regular level which we are using in the home, that is in the construction of houses, like marbles, granites, these are the things is also called as minerals. Even the cement and sand and iron, these are silver, these also are minerals. Even though which we are using in the kitchen, that's a copper, bronze, silver, and then you can see the steel, aluminium. So this all, even that our whites wire, that is for electrical supply wires, that is made with the aluminium. Even that copper is also, and the vehicles running with the petroleum diesel is also can found from the ground. And also the jewelry which we like, that's called as petroleum and diesel, is also found in the region of ground. So there is a lot of minerals which we have a regular usage. So the reason our topic was minerals and also called as mining. So which are the minerals which we are using and how these minerals are mining is our concept. So before I explain that, some different type of examples for the minerals, that is coal and also a mineral, copper, bronze, gold and silver and steel, petroleum, these all are the minerals. Even that gold and silver is also, water is also a mineral. So now minerals are divided into two types. One is called renewable resources and also called as non-renewable resources. So renewable minerals are else called as non-renewable minerals are else called resources. Renewable means the mineral which we can regenerate. The mineral which we can regenerate, or else called as reuses of the mineral, is called as renewable minerals. Example is wood. So wood we can get from the tree. Imagine that once if you cut the tree, after few years again the tree can be regenerate. So it means renewable minerals means the mineral which we can regenerate and reuses is called as renewable mineral. Example, a wood. The wood we are going to get from the tree, and even if you cut the tree, after few years that the tree again it can be generated. That you can say the renewable minerals are called as renewable resources. Non-renewable, the mineral which we cannot regenerate, or else called as reuses, is called as non-renewable minerals, or else called as non-renewable resources. Every mineral present is almost all the minerals that you can found in the non-renewable. Take an example, coal, which we can use one time, second time we cannot use the coal. Even the gold, we can make that jewelry and we can wear. Again, we cannot regenerate, or else called as reproduce. Okay, so there are two types of minerals. One is calling as renewable minerals. One is called as non-renewable minerals. Renewable and non-renewable. So renewable means the mineral which we can regenerate, or else reusage, is called as renewable mineral. Example, that is a wood. So wood can form from the tree, and once if you cut the tree, automatically that tree can be regenerate and again can give the food after few years of time. Non-renewable resources which we cannot regenerate and also reusage, that is called as non-renewable. Example, every mineral present in the modern days, almost all the minerals that you can found in the category of non-renewable resources only. So take an example, lot of minerals like a coal, silver, ragi, bronze, lead, copper and the gypsum. These all some different type of minerals. There is one, if we are going to be use these minerals, after usage of few years, these all the minerals are going to be complete. In the future, we cannot give these minerals to the our future generations. So the reason we have to use limited quantity, and we can provide these minerals to the future generation. That is one of the point. Take an example, one of the important mineral which we have more demand in the region of India, that is gold. And that gold can found in the Kolar gold field. And this Kolar gold field also having the limited resources. So because of that factor in the region of India, the gold is having the more demand. The gold is having the more demand. Because of the demand, the price of the gold is also increasing day by day. You see that the price of the gold is automatically is going for 10 grams of gold is going for 50,000 rupees. So it means the mineral which is having the limited quantity and the mineral is having that more demand, automatically the price of the gold is going to be increased. Now you see that important minerals in the region of Telangana. In the region of Telangana, first iron ore. So iron ore is a one the raw material which we can use for preparation of the iron and also the steel. So that iron ore that you can found in the region of Telangana, almost every district, particularly take that northern part of Telangana, and iron ore can found in the region of Telangana. And there are some other minerals like iron ore, mica, limestone, sandstone, granite, and also called as barites, and feldspar is also one which we are using in the region of home. Feldspar is a one mineral that can use in the preparation of wash basins. This all the things looks like in white color. See that one more time, what are the minerals are available in the region of Telangana? That one is called as iron ore and mica, barites, and called as feldspar, and limestone, granite, manganese. These are some different type of minerals are available in the region of Telangana. See this one more time. There is a called as one of the important place in the region of Telangana, Bayyaram Mills. You can say that Bayyaram. So here in the region of Bayyaram is a one of the field where the coal is iron is available. You can say that medium quality of iron ore that is available in the region of Bayyaram iron field. But Bayyaram is a place that you can find in the region of Telangana. Even that Kambam and Bhadradri Kottagodam, that is saying that Kambam and Bhadradri Kottagodam is also, there is a one type of iron, you can say that float iron, not very high quality, that is saying that normal quality. So float iron is available in the region of Kambam and also Bhadradri Kottagodam. So one more time, the Bayyaram is a one place that in the area there is a called as one of the medium quality iron ore is available. And also Kambam and also that Bhadradri Kottagodam, there also the float iron is available. Not only these two, Nizamabad, Peddapalli, and Warangal, here also in these areas also the iron. It means the Telangana is also an area which is having that iron ore available in these areas. Come to that other one is the preparation of cement. We require that limestone. So for preparation of cement, what is required? Limestone. The limestone is available in the region of Telangana, particularly the southern districts of Telangana like Mehboob Nagar and also called as Mehboobabad, Nagar Karnool and Karim Nagar, Adilabad. These are the areas are having that more cement. So what are the areas? Mehboobabad, Mehboob Nagar, Nagar Karnool, and also Karim Nagar, Adilabad. In these areas, the limestone is available, that you can say that the limestone is one which can use for preparation of cement industries. Next, there is a one of the mineral, you can say the granite. So brown granite is having that more demand in the region of Asian, western side of Asian countries. Even that other Asian countries are having the more demand with that the granite which can found in the region of Telangana. The granite is brown color. Granite is having more demand in the region of other Asian countries. that is maybe in the region of Singapore, Malaysia, Japan, in other countries, this granite is having that more demand. So India and Telangana is exporting this brown granite to the other Asian countries. Next one is, the region name is called as Lambapur and Nammapuram. This is called as Lambapur and Nammapuram. It's a two places that you can found in these two areas in the region of Nalgonda. This name is called as Nammapuram and also called as Lambapur. That's two can found in the region of Nalgonda. There, uranium. Uranium is a one of the top mineral that can be available in the region of Telangana, particularly in the region of Nalgonda district. The village name is called as Lambapuram and also called as Nammapuram. In these two areas, this uranium is available. And also, there is a how to do the mining. So now come to that, you understand that minerals. First, I explain what are the types of minerals is available in the region of Telangana and also in the region of home, what are the minerals which we are using that. And we know that what is mean by renewable minerals and what is mean by non-renewable minerals. And I given that different types of minerals which we can have in the region of Telangana, that is iron ore and also called as limestone and brown granite and some other minerals like uranium also. Now see that mining will take two ways. Mining will take two ways. One is called open cast mining and other one is calling as underground mining. The mining will take two places. One is called open cast mining, other one is calling as underground mining. What is mean by open cast mining and what is mean by underground mining? So take an example, this is called as a land and here there is a called as mineral, name is called as coal. So if you take this top layer that by digging the land, that is called as open cast mining. So on the land only by digging the land, we will take the mineral, that you can say that open cast mining. Underground mining means we'll keep the hole. Through this hole, people will go to the inside. Again, they will be keep the hole in the ground only. The mining which will take inside of the earth, that is calling as underground mining. So mining will take two ways. One is called open cast mining. One is called underground mining. The mining will take on the land is called as open cast mining. The mining can found in the ground, that you can say that underground mining. Now see that example for open cast mining and also called as underground mining. So in the region of Telangana, we have the company name is called as SCCL, Singareni Collieries Company Limited. What is that? So before of this topic, I'll cover one more topic. Okay, first you'll complete this lesson. This one, SCCL, SCCL, Singareni Collieries Company Limited. Singareni Collieries, C-O-L-L-E-R-I-E-S. Singareni Collieries Company Limited. First, when this company was started, this company comes under the control of British at the time of 1886. This company was formed at the time of 1886 by a private company. You can say that private British company, they started this in 1886 with the name of Singareni Coalfields. Then in 1886,
Later, this company was taken by Nizam in 1920. After independence of 1947, this company was taken by India and also called as Telangana government, called as Andhra Pradesh at the time common. So if you see the history of Singareni Coalfields, this company was formed at the time of 1886 with the British private company. Later, this company was taken by Nizam government in 1920. Later, this company, after the independence of India, this company is taken by Indian government. So the, now the company was comes under the control of state as well as central government control. That's why I'm saying that present it is a part of Telangana. So the reason this Singareni Collieries Company Limited comes under the control of India and also the Telangana. If you see this, what will happen, in which areas this can founded? There is in 15 areas there is going to be happen that open cast mining. Even in 35 places it is going with the underground mining. So there is a mining is happening in the region of Telangana, particularly by the under the supervision of company limited. There is in 15 places that is open cast mining is happening. Through these areas they will take the coal. Other in 35 areas there is a underground mining is happening. That if you see that there are, this area is comes under four districts in the region of Telangana. It was comes under the control of four districts. And come to that, first there are 65,000 people are working in this SCCL. How many members are working? 65,000 people are working under this SCCL company. We know that Kottagodam is very famous for the Singareni. There is also Kottagodam and Khammam site and also Karimnagar, Warangal site. Also the people, they are working in the region of Singareni company only. Come to that, according to the 2015 census, there are 65,000 people are working in SCCL company, either in the open cast mining or else called as underground mining. So what to do that, how to know about this one? Come to that, the people, those who prepared this lesson, they prepared this lesson by visiting to the SCCL company. First, two teachers started journey from Hyderabad. From Hyderabad, they reached the Kottagodam. And after reaching to the Kottagodam, in the region of Kottagodam, they have that SCCL office. They taken the permission to go to that company. That's a place where underground mining is occurred. So they from Kottagodam to, they travel to the place name is called as Yellanthu. What the place name is called as Yellanthu. It's a place where the teachers was travel. Even this is in a place they are showing in the movies also. So first Hyderabad to Kottagodam, and from in the Kottagodam they taken the permission in the SCCL office. Later they travel 40 km distance from Kottagodam to Yellanthu. At this distance was 40 km where the underground mining is occurred. Later in the Yellanthu also they taken that in the office of SCCL, they taken the permission, and there they allotted one officer, safety officer. And now these two teachers along with the safety officer, they going to the incline number 21. So incline number means where the underground mining 21 place where the underground mining is happened. So there they travel. So when this person, the safety officer, explain the position, how the mining is occurring in the region of underground, and what are the steps we have to follow, everything. So you can find there are some of the pictures was given in the textbook, but I don't want to complete each and everything because we don't have too much time. First, the safety officer taken, and there is a call as one of the like a lift. The lift will be like this, and this one starts from here, from on the top. This is called as a land. From here, it's the lift. The lift is looks like in one box, covered with the four sides of one iron rods, and the two teachers and a safety officers were sitting here, and they were taken that one you can say that helmet along with the light. They travel. When they are traveling into that ground, it means they're going to the underground. These other two teachers observed that there are some of the water is falling at the time. When the teachers are asking to the safety officer what is the water, they're saying that when they are doing that mining, underground water, I means the ground water will be splitted, and that's the water. And also they will take out this water to the bore wells. I can say that through the motors they will remove this water also, and they will go into that long distance. And also they have the railway track. So once upon a time, when the technology was not developed at the time, there is a people can be take this complete coal through the physically only. And nowadays they have the like a small railway wagons, like a small boxes, they'll be dumped into that one. And these are the railway boxes they will take. Even that every time they have some instructions, and there is some called a horn, or else called siren. Before coming into this one, they'll give a one bell one time or two time or three times. That's a one instruction which that is a one vehicle is coming into that mining. The safety officer explained, and inside they also, because they found that inside of this 21 incline, the coal is looks like in white color. Because the safety officer explained that if we are leaving that coal that looks like a dark color, we cannot see anything. So they painted with the dolomite. Dolomite is a one type of chemical. They are going to paint it on the dolomite, and that paint would be looks like in white color. So inside, because of visible purpose, there inside of the ground they will be painted with the dolomite. And also they call as one type of wooden support, otherwise called as wooden sleeve. So inside of the mining, how the mining is going to be happen here, this is called as coal. Before of taking the coal, they'll keep the hole to this one, and there are some detonators like bombs. The bombs will be this much like this. They have some connecting with the wires, so they'll keep the hole to this mine, otherwise called coal. And they'll go to the long distance, the 500 or 1000 feet of distance. Then here they have a support, and top will be like in a completely covered, and the sides is also. And they will blast this one. When the blast was occurred, the complete inside of the ground will be resounded, and a complete area is expanding with the smoke. And because of that, there is a lot of health problems are going to be occurs inside only. So these are the people, they will be goes inside of this iron supporters, otherwise called wooden supporters, because to save, if any, because sometime when the blast was occurred, the top of the ground is also fallen. To for the purpose of saving from this one, they will be inside of the frame. They will wait for 2 or 3 minutes or else cause some of the time till after completion of the smoke. The smoke can be ejected, then they will take out the coal.
So there are some different type of departments. There are some members will arrange these frames. There are some members will keep the holes. There are some members they'll keep the detonators and the blasting. There is the blasting departments, and also after the blasting they will take the coal also. So these are some different type of departments are working in the region of underground mining. So compare with the open mining, underground mining is so danger, and there is a lot of accidents are going to be occur. Sometimes the ground water is also released too much, and we seeing that mining is a dangerous job. Because of this mining also lot of people is also occurred accidents, and that was showing in the movies also. There are sometime the underground water will be drawn with complete mine. Sometimes poisonous gases are going to be released. Sometimes the top ground is going to be fallen on those people. This all the accidents are going to be happen, and this is a once upon a time this is in a position, but nowadays there's a lot of safety measures are have taken by the people. So the reason they are avoiding some of the accidents. Okay, so that's a one of the point, and come to that, not only this, we have that safety helmets are there, and everything present is. And but the problem is, what are the welfare? So welfare of this SCCL, government is providing the schools and also the hospitals and houses to the workers with the limit with the less charges. So the reason the government of India and also the government of Telangana is working for the development of all the workers. So the reason they are giving that lot of priority to the people. So the reason they are providing that lot of free, almost free education, but they're collecting with limited fees. So limited school fees, limited college fees, and also that providing that hospitals for the small issues. And even that playgrounds, even the cinema theaters, everything is going to be arranging with the limited price. Next come to that, what are the other systems? So government is also providing that lot of medical treatment also, because those who are working in the underground mining, because of the smoke, because they have to be take that lot of smoke, because of this one there is a called as black lung diseases. Like a TB, tuberculosis, these all the things are going to be occurs. The people, those who are working in the region of underground mining, for the purpose of to stop the black lung diseases. So person, those who are joined. So the people, those who have that age of 45 years, so less than 45 years of people, for every 5 years they have to go for one time checkup. And if the people they have that more than 45 years of age, they'll go for 3 times for checking. It means if you fellows, those who join, if the young people they have that more immunity, for the reason they will take the medical checkup for every 5 years, and above 45 years people they will take that for every 3 years once they have to check for medical checkup to stop that all the lung diseases problems, black lung diseases problems. These all the problems are going to be occurs. Now come to that other one. Once one more thing is, we have that who is the owner of these all the minerals, like in limestone, these all things. So we know that all minerals can found in the ground. So there is no owner of these all the minerals. Once upon a time, private people are taking the minerals and they are selling, so they are getting that huge profits. That's a once upon a time this is happening before of the independence. So private people will take the minerals, they will never concentrate on the people. They are taking that mineral, but they never think about the welfare and the benefit of the workers. That's a before of independence. After 1970s, government was taking all the minerals which we have in the region of India. All minerals was taken by government under the supervision of government only. Mining is occurred, and all the things they are mined, and all the employees is also comes under the control of government.
the profit is also taken by the government and everything. So that is according to the 1970s act, the given priority for all the minerals should be converting into the government. They are using for the purpose of public purpose only. But after 1993, there were some changes where you can say that new national mineral policy was occurred. According to this one, there are some of the minerals, the contract was given to the private people because private people will provide more facilities compared with the government sector. And like in new technology in the region of mining. So because of that factor, they given chance for private. So from 1993, according to the new mineral policy, with this policy, they allowed that private people also will take the mining by providing the proper infrastructure and proper facilities to the people for the mining also. These all the things we cannot be providing by the governments. So the reason, because of the new technological purpose, they given chance for private. So nowadays private and also the government is also doing that mining. But some of the minerals like uranium, these are the nuclear minerals. These minerals are taken only by the government. This is about the underground mining. Come to the next, we have that open cast mining. Open cast mining we have in the region of Kottagudem, where the name is called Sattupalli. So Sattupalli, everyone knows that there is a college. One more mineral name, mining name is called as open cast mining. There you can find this Jalagam Vengalrao mining. It's a one of the mining. They are using that bulldozers, tractors, lorries, and some different type of instruments for digging the land, and with the electrical instruments they are using, because this is in a Jalagam Vengalrao mining, the point which was held in the region of Sattupalli in 2005. And by using that new modern equipments, they are also doing that mining. So in this place there are 700 employees are working in this place, and out of 700, 400 employees was government employees, can say the permanent employees. The balance 300 is contract, otherwise called as regular employees. So what will happen? So because there is a college, compared with the underground mining, open cast mining somewhat less danger, because underground mining is so danger and a lot of problem will occur because of underground mining. And also the underground mining is more expensive compared with the open cast mining. Open cast mining is less expenditure and compared with the underground mining. But because of open cast mining, the problem is the pollution problem will occur. Because of this one, lot of pollution can be released, lot of trees should be lost. These are the problem because of the open cast mining. But there is also called as pollution, not only the air pollution, water pollution will also occur, because after the mining they have to clean that minerals by using the water. After cleaning the minerals, this is in a way the water which cleaned minerals, that you can say that we cannot use for drinking and other purpose. This water can be mixed or is called a joint in the region of river. Because of that, the rivers are also polluted. So lot of pollution problem will occur because of the mining. So this is your small topic. Then we will meet you that next, and we have that one more video class, the doubts which you have, that you can ask to me that. So just I roughly completed, because actually this lesson will take 3 or 4 periods of time, but I covered in one period. But after this reopen of the school, again I'm trying to be complete the points which we miss it. And also once now you read the lesson, which are the doubts you have, that the